For the past few days, I've been training Angela in preparation for the most dangerous finale we've ever attempted on the show. She doesn't know what's in store, or even that she's picked a trick, but today is the final part of her lesson before she's kidnapped.
So I haven't really given you any indication of really where we're going with this.
Why?
You're just learning some skills, which will all come together at the end. I'd like you just to look at me right here.
Yeah.
But as you look at me, you're going to feel your eyelids just start to get a little heavier. And as you kind of listen to me and just let yourself relax. That's right. And heavier. And it becomes more of a struggle. That's right. Just drift down. Imagine yourself tied securely. And through no effort on your part, other than just focusing your attention, and in the same way you can command a muscle to relax, you can also command the knot to relax. And just see those knots just slipping away. Now what I'd like you to do is to not only wake up, but to feel a refreshment moving through you. Feel good?
Yeah.
All right. Grab your napkin. Stand up for me. Now, I'll tie this up. Now, if you give that a good pull, I need you to see they don't just come apart. All right, I'd like you to unpick it for me. And what happens, what you experience, is an increasing sense of frustration and annoyance, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. That feeling now, that you're feeling, is the feeling that is important. And that's what is going to drive this mediumistic state for you. I'm going to tie another knot. That's pretty much as tight as it's going to go. I should probably give that one more. Okay? I'll give it another tie. Really tight. Sensational. Okay, this is excellent. Okay, that's as tight as it's going to go, I think. Okay, so if I can take your hand, what you can do is you're going to put your hand over the knot, all right? Just gently like that. You can feel the knot underneath, yes?
Yeah, I can feel that. Okay.
And just keep imagining now as there's three or four knots, you're just going to create that mediumistic state and you just command those knots to come apart. I take a deep breath in. Just command it to happen. Then reach over with that hand, just pull one away and see if it comes. Look, look. Incredible. You've got that spot on. What does it feel like?
I can really feel the difference in my hand.
And it just melts
energy,
apart?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Congratulations. That's fantastic.
For the next few days, training continues for Angela. Over this short period of time, she has honed her physical fitness and her mental acuity and has inadvertently been taught all the elements she'll need to see her through the trick I've planned for her. Although she doesn't realize it, Angela's safety will depend on what she now knows.
Congratulations, you are more than ready for what I have in mind.
We then broke off all contact with Angela, and we left it for 2 months. The last time we spoke, I told her we'd be continuing filming at some point in the future, but I left the details deliberately sketchy. However, after 8 weeks of silence, it's now time to bring her journey to an end. It's 4:30 a.m. on a Tuesday morning. Without her knowledge, we've managed to obtain a spare key to her house.
Angela, Angela, wake up, wake up.
Oh.
Derren sent us. Your trick is about to begin. Put these on. There's a wetsuit and a boiler suit.
Her abductors have been instructed to restrain her hands with two genuine police-issue cable ties looped tightly together. They're designed to be impossible to remove. She's also being blindfolded to make sure she can't see where she's being taken.
This way.
Finally, her legs are bound again and again with gaffer tape. With her hands and feet securely bound, she has no possibility of conventional escape.
We have to go. We're on our way.
Angela will now be delivered to me. She has no concept of where she is going or what is about to happen to her. She has a long, dark journey to her final destination. That's with her wrists cable tied together, her ankles gaffer taped securely, unable to see, trying to remain calm and hopefully using the time to access the mediumistic state that she's learnt. Eventually she arrives at Black Park Lake. This early in the morning the water temperature is barely 8 degrees Celsius. There's a fixed camera under the water. Other than that, Angela is on her own. Her abductors check that her hands and feet are still both securely bound and so bring her out to meet me.
Angela, it's Derren. I'm just going to take your blindfold off. My eyes might need a moment to adjust. I'm going to pop you in the sack. Just sit still for the moment. Okay. Now I'm going to tie this over here. I won't do anything until you're absolutely ready. Pop your head in for me. Now, I will count down from 3 to 0. On 0, I'll tip you in. Okay. You ready to do this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Do whatever you need to do. Do any breathing that you need to. Three. Two. One. Zero. Off you go. There's a ladder around here. Do you want to come around this side? Show me hands. Hands apart. Feet okay?
Yep.
Amazing. Well, let's get you warm.
It has all been a really interesting experience. I don't know how this worked. It's good to sort of learn about yourself as well, so I don't think I'd usually push myself that hard. Derren said to use the technique to stay calm because it was really, really cold in there. Luckily I got out of there in the end.
For Derren Brown DVDs, including his new release, Something Wicked This Way Comes, go to channel4.com/shop. Tonight on Gordon Ramsay's F Word, boxer Ricky Hatton provides some food for thought at 5 past 11. Next on 4, Jeremy's mum has a new fella in Peep Show.